Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle and the radius of triangle ABD and the radius of triangle DEC are given 1 unit square and then these two angles are given equal and these are given as 90 degrees. The question is, what is the radius of the blue shaded triangle? Okay. First step, let's call here x. That means this length must be equal 2 over x, right? Why? Because notice that the radius of this triangle equal 1 unit square. Next step, let's call here angle theta. We know that straight angle equals 180 degrees, so theta plus alpha plus 90 degrees equal 180 degrees. That means alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees, right? So if you focus on this triangle, if here is theta, that means this angle must be equal alpha. Therefore, we get an angle bisector. To calculate the radius of the triangle, we need a height, right? So let's draw a perpendicular like this. If you focus on this triangle, notice that here is alpha, that means here must be equal theta, right? Therefore, we get two congruent triangles. If you notice that these two triangles have same angles and same height patterns, that means these two triangles are exactly congruent. So triangle BAD and triangle, let's call here point K, BKD are congruent. Right? Therefore, if there's an x unit opposite of the alpha, opposite of the alpha must be equal x unit. Likewise, if there's a 2 over x opposite of the theta, opposite of the theta must be equal 2 over x unit. Next step, let's call here m. For this triangle, we can apply Euclid's theorem, right? Therefore, according to Euclid's theorem, x squared equal 2 over x times m. So that means m equal x cubed over 2. Right? Let's write here x cubed over 2. After that, let's call here z. If we calculate the radius of this triangle, x times z over 2, right? X times z over 2 must be equal this triangle area, right? Because they have same areas. X times 2 over x over 2. So, if we simplify the expression, these are again, that means z equal 2 over x. Let's write here, z equal 2 over x. And notice that here is 90 degrees, right? That means the this angle must be equal alpha. Therefore, we get one more angle bisector. So let's call here y. According to angle bisector theorem, let me clear here. So for this triangle, if we apply angle bisector theorem, the ratio of x to y, x over y, must be equal the ratio of these two parts, x cubed over 2 over 2 over x, right? So x over y equal x cubed over 2 times x over 2. If we simplify the expression, these are again, that means y equal 4 over x cubed. Let's write here 4 over x cubed. If you notice, we had calculated all unknowns in terms of x, right? Now, whether it's in this triangle or even in the biggest triangle, you can find the value of x by applying the Pythagorean theorem. Or you can use the angle bisector theorem like I did. So let me clear here. For triangle ABC, we can apply angle bisector theorem. So ratio of these two sides, 2 over x, must be equal ratio of these two sides. So 2 over x plus 2 over x plus x cubed over 2 over 4 over x cubed. Therefore, 2 over x squared equal 2 over x plus 2 over x equal 4 over x, right? So if we equalize numerator and denominator, 8 plus x to the power of 4 over 2x times x cubed over 4. So if you simplify the expression, these are again, and 16 equal 8 plus x to the power of 4 times x to the power of 4. So let's call x to the power of 4 as t, and let's clear here. Therefore, 8 plus t times t equal 16, right? So t squared plus 8t minus 16 equals 0. Let's convert this expression to a perfect square. T plus 4 whole squared minus 16 minus 16 equals 0. So t plus 4 whole squared equal 32 a square root both sides of the equation. That means t plus 4 equal 4 root 2. So t is going to be 4 root 2 minus 4. We know that t equal x to the power of 4, right? And also we know that this triangle and this triangle have same areas, right? Because these are congruent triangles. Therefore, if you calculate the area of this triangle, we will have found the area of the blue shaded triangle. So the area of the triangle DKE must be equal x times x cubed over 4. So x to the power of 4 over 4. Therefore, if you divide both sides of the equation by 4, we get the area of triangle DKE. Right? That's right here, root 2 minus 1. So now we can calculate the area of blue shaded triangle easily, right? So 1 plus root 2 minus 1 is again. That means the area of the blue shaded triangle is root 2 units square. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.